Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad to welcome you back. In this particular session, we are going to see all the stories I've been telling you in the previous session, how they will play a part in us being able to solve some mathematical problems involving binary operation. On the screen, we can take the first example, as you can see, where we are asked to find the value for 2 star 4, 1 star minus 1, 3 star into 5 star 2, also the identity element and the inverse of 10 under the operation star for a particular binary operation, which is defined as A star B to be equal to A plus B plus AB. Alright, so we have A star B, the operation is star, defined as A star B to be equal to A plus B plus AB. Now on the screen, the first thing we have to find is 2 star 4, which of course is very simple. We have 2 star 4 at this point, so we have 2 star 4. Comparing 2 star 4 to A star B, that means our first operand is A, which has now been replaced as 2, and our second operand is 4, which has now been replaced as B. Sorry, our second operand is B, which has now been replaced as 4. So wherever we see A, we are going to fix 2 on the right hand side, and wherever we see B, we are going to fix 4 also on the right hand side. So A plus B now becomes 2 plus 4, because here A means 2 and B means 4. Okay, so A plus B now means 2 plus 4 plus AB means 2 times 4. Of course, you know that AB means multiplication. So this equals to 2 plus 4 will give us 6, plus 2 times 4 here will give us 8. Okay, so that means that 2 star 4 is equal to the single value 6 plus 8. And 6 plus 8 of course will give us 14. That is the value for 2 star 4, given the binary operation A star B being defined as A plus B plus AB. Alright, the next guy we are asked to find from our list is 1 star minus 2. You can see that on the screen. The second one is 1 star minus 2. So we also have that we are still using the same binary operation. So our A star B was equal to A plus B plus AB. So if we are looking for 1 star minus 2 now, meaning that A is now 1 star minus 2, so B is now minus 1. So on the right hand side, wherever we see A, we'll replace it as 1, and wherever we see B, we'll replace it as minus 2. So here is going to be A plus B now becomes 1 plus B is minus 2 plus AB is now 1 times minus 2. Okay, so if we simplify this, we have 1 plus minus 2, you know, plus minus is minus, so 1 plus minus 2 will still give us minus 2. Then here we also have 1 times minus 2 here is minus 2. So with this other guy here, which is the plus sign, will still give us minus 2. So that means that 1 star minus 2 is equal to 1 minus 2 will give us minus 1, and minus 1 minus 2 will give us minus 3. So that becomes the value for 1 star minus 2. So this thing is simple. Once a binary operation is defined, which will always be defined for you by the examiner, and you are asked to find anything, you just replace the first operand by the first guy you are asked to find, and also the second operand by the second guy that stays there in that particular question. Alright, but sometimes you can be given more than two operands, like our third example now. We are asked to find 3 star 5 star 2. So we are going to pick the bracket face, which is 5 star 2, and evaluate before we now use that answer to start with 3. So 3 star 5 star 2 means we find 5 star 2 first. Okay, so our binary operation is still A star B to be equal to A plus B plus AB, and we are now asked to find 3 star 5 star 2. We can't take all the three guys at the same time, so we are going to take the bracket first, which is 5 star 2. So we find 5 star 2 first, which means that, sorry, this is not B, this is 2, so we have 5 star 2. So which means that A is now 5, and of course B is now 2. So A plus B will now give us 5 plus 2 plus A times B will give us 5 times 2. So this equals to 5 plus 2 of course is 7, plus 5 times 2 of course is 10. So that means that 5 star 2 is actually equals to what? 17. So this bracket is now 17. we now go ahead and find 3*17, because 17 is now the value for 5*2, which was our bracket. So we now use it to start with 3. So we now define 3*17, which is equals to A is now 3 and B is now 17. So A plus B will give us 3+17 plus AB, of course, will give us 3×17. Okay, so 3+17, of course, is 20, and 3×17, that's 17 × 3. 3×7 is 21. You write 1 and carry 2. 3×1, of course, is 3+1 is 5. So 17 × 3 will give us 51. So we have 51 here. Okay, so 3*17 now becomes 20+51. Of course, that's going to give us 71. That is now the value for 3*5*2. So when you are asked to find something that is more than 2, it will always be paid. You have a pay of it first, which is the bracket. You pick the bracket first and evaluate before you now use it with the other element. Because what we are talking about is binary operation, meaning it always works with two operands at a time. So you always pick the bracket first, evaluate it first before you join it to the last guy. Okay, still on our screen, we are asked to find the identity element as far as the operation star is concerned. Okay, now this is how that is done. Look at this very carefully. Now we have A*B to be equals to A+B+AB. That's our A*B. We are now asked to find the identity element. Now for identity, I told you earlier that anytime you operate an identity with a number, it will always return that number. So our operation is star, meaning A*E, let E represent the identity now. So A*E should always give me A. That's what it means. A*E should always give me A, so that I can conclude that E is my identity. 2+0 is 2, making 0 the identity. The operation here is not plus, it's star. So A*E should be equals to A, making E the identity. So what we had earlier was A*B being defined as A+B+AB. So I'm going to define A*E now and equate that answer to A. Okay, so A*E now means A is still A and B is now E. So wherever I see B, I'm going to replace it as E. So this is going to give us A+E+AE, because AB here is now AE, and this should give us A. A*E should be equals to A, making E the identity. So I have to equate it to A. So here we are left with A+E+AE is equals to A. I can take this A to this other side, that subtract A from both sides. So I'm going to have AE+AE to be equals to A-A. I'm taking the A on the left hand side to the right hand side to become minus A. So here I'm going to have E+AE to be equals to A-A will give us 0. And here, since I'm looking for E, I can factorize E out of this left hand side. So I have E into 1+A to be equals to 0. And if I make E the subject, I divide both sides of the equation by 1+A. So that will give me 0/1+A. And once you say 0 divided by anything, it's still equals to 0. So E is equals to 0. As far as the operation star is concerned, the identity is 0. This 0 is not fixed for all operations. Depending on what the examiner presents to you in the examination hall, you always be expected to find the identity. And you should always define it as, if the operation is star, so A*E is equals to A, and you replace it back into the binary operation. If the operation is delta, A*E is equals to A, and you fix it back into the operation and equate it to A. With that, you'll be able to find your identity. And finally, for that question, we're asked to find the inverse of 10 under the operation star. Okay, so here we are looking for inverse. Our binary operation is A*B to be equals to A+B+AE. I told you that how to find the inverse of a number is simply thinking of a number that when you use it with that particular number in an operation, it will return the identity back. If I'm looking for the inverse of 10, I will say that, okay, let the inverse of 10 be y or be anything. So let the inverse of 10 be y. So that means that 10*y should be equals to e. 2 plus minus 2 gives us 0, making minus 2 the inverse of 2. Okay? So if the inverse of 10 is y and the operation is star, so 10 star y should always give me the identity. Okay? Alright. So we now have a star b, which is our binary operation, which was defined as a plus b plus ab. That was our binary operation. This place is b, not e. Okay? So our binary operation is a star b and is equals to a plus b plus ab. I'm now looking for 10 star y, where y means the inverse of 10. Okay? So I'll define 10 star y, and this will be equals to what? This place here, a is 10, because that's the phase operands now. So I have 10 plus y plus this ab now becomes 10 y. Okay? And this is equals to e. And e here was our identity, which was 0, which we did in the previous question. E for this binary operation was 0. So what that tells you is that you must always find the identity phase before you can find inverse, because you'll be equating that inverse relationship to the identity. If the examiner asks you to find the inverse for a particular question without the identity phase, you as a good student should know that you are going to find the identity first before you attempt finding the inverse, because you always be equating that relationship to the identity. So here I'm equating it to 0, which was our identity in the previous example I did. So this now equals to 10 plus y plus 10 y will give us 11 y, and this equals to 0. I'm trying to make y the subject, so I have 11 y is equals to 10 to this side will give us 0 minus 10. That will be minus 10. So y here is now equals to minus 10 divided by what? 11. We said earlier, let y be the inverse of 10. So the inverse of 10 we have, as far as this operation is concerned, is actually minus 10 over 11. That is the inverse of 10 as far as the binary operation star is concerned. That has been our example number one. And I'm sure that since the video is at your disposal, you can always play it back as many times as possible in order to be able to get the full understanding of what I just finished explaining. We still have example number two, which we are going to look at it. Of course, you can see it on your screen. So let's look at example number two.